Two Megapops is an achievement in Blue Tower Defense 6 where one of your towers that you put down in a CHIMPS game has to get 2 million or more pops throughout the entire game. And today we're going to be doing this with the Hydra Rocket Pods. We've yet to do either of these two, done mad, but we have yet to do either of these two, but we're just going to go with the non-ability part. Starting us off, we have a good old reliable monkey sub because we can just put this under the submersion support status later on and be able to ensure that it doesn't do any damage later on. And thank goodness that that dart sniped that single red balloon up there, otherwise we'd have to start the round again. As you know, that sometimes the most difficult round in the entire game of CHIMPS is round 6. Just getting your feet on the floor sometimes is worse than actually progressing through round 98. Bit of micro required on this spot. Hopefully I'll be able to get through it. If not, then I have to resort to the good old look up a video and see how I go from there. But luckily I was able to do that round. So let's put down Geraldo there. Or should I put Geraldo over here? Just hoping that okay, we'll put Geraldo over here actually. That's a little bit of defense on our six here, but not enough defense, but should be able to get a few red balloons here and there. But if it's not going to get through this, then we're going to have to rethink our strategy here. I may have to extend the time in which we need to put down Geraldo so that we can just get through these rounds, because honestly it's a little bit of a struggle at the moment just getting through round 9 of all rounds. Actually, how much is it to Pickles? Pickles is, if I can press it correctly, that's 110. Yeah, that's going to be a bit interesting to see if we can get it or not. Should I just put a stack of old nails at the end of the track here? Yeah, I think we'll do that just once and hope we're able to put some pickles down for the next round. There we go. Hopefully soon we should be able to put down our Dartling Gunner. Longer range, and soon we're going to get some barb darts because I do want that lead popping. Like, we could put down an alchemist which will support our Dartling Gunner, but it's not the most reliable means of granting a tower lead popping potential when the acidic mixture dip feels like it's barely on the tower itself, especially when it fires at the rate like the Dartling Gunner does. So barb darts, heat tip darts for that increased pierce. Bunch of yellow balloons, no match for us. Okay, so pink balloons. We're gonna put this on strong, and losing your pickles is not always a bad thing because we do have more attack speed, but it just comes at a cost of being able to get through these rounds, and thanks to the pierce, we're able to go through more of these balloons right here. So we now have the money for our Dartling Gunner. Now it's just a matter of where to put it. I'm gonna put you over here actually, so we have a bit of line of sight, so we can aim down here, be able to get to this point, over here, along here, all the good stuff. Maybe I didn't put it down far enough, but I think where it is optimal. Now, cross pathing, we're going to go with top path so that we're actually able to fire down a line, although we do have the penalty of not having as much pierce because we're not going bottom path, but I feel like with quarter arms, we're going to be just fine on the pierce part. Advanced targeting so that we can actually target the camo balloon on round 24. Don't need to require the submersion support just yet. That's only going to be for later on so that this no longer steals pops. Here's round 24 and the green camo's gone. Let's get both pickles and the sharpening stone so that we have more pierce and more attack power per dart. Would really help us out in the next few rounds here. Will really help us out until we get Hydra Rocket Pods, and then from there, do we need pickles? I think we do because each rocket is not that strong, but lead balloons. We'll unleash that. We're going to get ourselves some submersion support so that we no longer require this unless there's going to be a lead issue involved, just like this round. So press U. And then once you're done popping all of the leads on this round, then... Oh, great. Well, I thought it's fired enough of them so I can actually get through the layer there. Oh, put down more pickles, for goodness sakes, because pickles likes to only last for 5 rounds, just like a perma spike, despite its name, only lasts for 5 rounds maximum. Can this reach the Dartling Gunner? Yes, it can. And if this was a blank board and that didn't reach, that would require a restart. Or just put a village nearby so that it benefits both the Alchemist and the Dartling Gunner here. But rather, a village only benefits the Dartling Gunner so that this doesn't increase its range and be able to hit more Moabs. Can't hit cameras from this distance, but I'm pretty sure it can hit ZMGs if they're along this point here. And we require both Dartling Gunner and... Sharpening Stone and Pickles. We need both. We need both for these next few rounds, because this just does not have the popping potential to be able to get through these rounds. Although I'm sure there are people crazy enough out there to do base Dartling, which essentially means tier 2 or below upgrades on a particular tower. Great. Just what I want. Lead balloons to tackle with... Please pop them, please pop them. Thank you. Now, you go back to being submerged so I can continue with the rest of this in peace. Not pieces. Just a small cache, though. Round 38 also has leads on it. So that's fantastic. Again, can't really rely on the Alchemist to pop all of the leads. Just because the acidic mixture is barely on the tower. Look at that. It's almost gone instantaneously. Hydra Rocket Pods, though, is online, which means we've got more pierce and more, like, popping potential per projectile. I'm just going to say projectile rather than per dart, because it's no longer a dart. It's a missile stronger stimulant. And no, we are not applying the perishing potions. There is no need to put it on, because of the second vein, which means it removes the fortified layer off of smaller balloons. Think about how much that's going to steal on round 98. Got jungle drums for now. We will eventually go for call to arms, but that's not necessary right now because we have innate camera detection and we don't have any issues with our Hydra Rocket Pods being able to pop any kind of balloon in general, because the Hydra Rocket Pods can pop all kinds of balloons. It's a normal type of attack. Although Ninja Kiri, I suspect one day will change this from normal to explosive, just like they changed the biggest one from normal to explosion. Despite the fact that there's no patch notes regarding the biggest one, even though there is for the big one. I'm gonna think about Jerry's Fire for a while. Possibly like to like the 90s, we'll probably place one down. Because this has enough power on its own, along with the support we're going to give it, so that we're able to be quite self-sufficient without Jerry's Fire itself. Like, for some towers, it's an absolute necessity. I'm talking about ones like Super Glue, for example, which is now actually possible to do. But I have yet to come up with a strategy in order to try and do that for myself. So if you have any tips for that one, then please let me know down in the comment section below. I bet there's going to be a few people out there that are far better at this game than I am. And I say far better, I don't have a high standard of myself. Like, I always say this to myself, I don't think I'm a very good player at this game. And that's not just because, like, I'm doubting myself or anything like that. I just genuinely think that I am not a very good player at this game. I think there are loads of people out there that have the innate talent in order to be actually much better than I am at the game. I just think I have a lot of perseverance when it comes to this sort of thing, which is a skill or a good trait in and of itself to have when it comes to these sort of challenges, is the perseverance to not give up in the face of failure. And I feel like there's something that a lot of people can learn from, is the fact that with your current set of skills, there is always room for improvement for both yourself and for others in a way. So in this case, people sometimes expect me to do something that is far more than I'm actually able of doing. So when people say, like, geared chimps is super easy, like, why you complain about it? It's so easy. I've done it thousands of times. Why can't you do it one time? And I think people forget that the perception of difficulty is different for each and every one of us. So your version of easy is my version of hard. My version of hard is your version of easy. Depending on what it is that you are striving to achieve. Some people may require hundreds of hours in order to do the one thing that you're able to do in 10 minutes. And it's not because we are any less capable of doing it It's because your experience, your talents, your traits, your advantages and disadvantages enables you to get to that point much more quickly than other people. And I feel like elitists have no concept of other people, because the only thing that they can think of is themselves and their own talents and their own strengths, and they feel like they don't have any weaknesses whatsoever. And they allow that elitism to get the better of them, to where they just see everybody as the same as them. If not, then they don't deserve to exist whatsoever, because they feel like they have a superiority complex in comparison to those that they deem unworthy or unnecessary or a nuisance or just something that is cruel. Even with overclock, it feels like our rate of fire has barely increased whatsoever. We're struggling through these rounds, and it's not the Moabs which is the biggest problem. I feel like it's fortified ceramics at the moment, so I need to find some way in order to slow down the balloons, or for the balloons to be able to receive more damage, or with a middle path glue gunner we can do both, which we will get at some point. But I'm thinking about slowing down those Moabs, so I'm thinking of putting down a glue gunner over here, a 013 for a moment, so that we're not sticking just one Moab, we're sticking more than one. And it's only two, but two is better than one. Only supply a half of them than it would normally need. Obviously six is more required, but not at this given point in time. And sometimes it's good to disperse out the Moabs if they're in a group, just so that they're not always clumped together, so that the Pierce can be a bit more dispersed, even though I know I'm kind of trying to be a bit fantastical with my demands here. We're going to go to call to arms now, because even though MIB radar scanner and in a way regrow blocker is useless on our Hydra Rocket Pods, call to arms is not useless, but it just requires those other three upgrades in order to actually make call to arms actually work. There's no skip function. It's not like we can remove this upgrade so you can get to a particular upgrade, which would be a rather specific request to ask Ninja Kiri, hey, I would like to skip out on radar scanner and MIB and regrow blocker just so that I can have this one very specific thing which enables my attack speed to increase. Moab's going down. Okay, so ceramics, let's see how it gets along with these ceramics. And that is going to be a yeah, this is quite a concern. Maybe I need pickles actually to increase our attack potential, because it feels like each projectile is weak, so getting pickles would actually be more of a benefit than a curse right about now. And yeah, for a tower which is weak per projectile and power, getting pickles is more of a benefit than a hindrance, whereas something like Pat Butsy, for example, which has low attack rate but a high amount of damage per attack, getting pickles would actually be more of a hindrance than a benefit. Let's see. I actually want to avoid that glued red balloon, because I just want to have a bit of, a bit of breathing room here. So what am I going to contemplate next on the agenda? I do want the glue strike at some point. Going to pop you lot now, and then we're going to apply pickles to our Hydra Rocket Pods. So is that going to make things easier for us? Especially against, like, it's not... Oh, it does do increased damage to fortified balloons at this point. Good, good. And the next stage, when the pickles get even better, they'll do even more damage against fortified balloons. Yeah, pickles is really helping us out, especially with the Moabs, because it feels like we're doing much more damage against them now. Thanks to having pickles, we do lose a bit of attack speed, but I feel like per projectile, we're getting much more out of them. Combining both pickles and glue strike, I think our damage potential goes up by about +3 or +4 or +5 when it comes to like fortified balloons, because I think glue strike gives +2 damage when applied to a balloon upon its activation. And pickles, I'm not certain how much bonus damage it applies to per projectile. It's like +1 normal balloons, and then like +2 or 3 with fortified balloons. I'm not too sure. You're asking the wrong person here. I don't data mine the game or always look up the wiki to see the actual statistics of all of these things. All I know is that it does increase it. I don't know the exact numbers. Eyelashes protects eyes. Also eyelashes attacks eyes. You get that sometimes where you have an eyelash, it just falls down and then it just falls into your eyes. I had one of those today at work and I swear somebody was thinking that I was looking at them in an irritated way, and it's like, I'm really sorry. Unfortunately, I've got something in my eye at the moment and it's making me look like I'm angrier than I actually am. And in retail work, it's like, you have to look pristine and perfect, otherwise it feels like customers will always see you as being cross towards them. And I'm saying, I only am going to genuinely look like this if a customer is annoying me. And you do get that times where I think customers are just born out of the back end rather than the front end, if you get what I mean. Because they just exist to make other people's lives more miserable. I just realized we've run out of pickles, and I feel like we definitely need it. Not for the rest of this round, though, because we're good with this? No, of course not. There's a BFB on this round. Balloonist Tuber forgets what is going on in a round. Automatic cancellation for forgetting there's a BFB on round 74. But now we're on round 75. You know, sometimes when you're waiting for an ability to recharge, just leave a red balloon or something. There's no harm in leaving a red balloon because it's not going to give you any harm. Like, there's like Geraldo and your engineer at the back here. So if you do forget, then you do have some defense at the back of here to ensure that you don't leave that red balloon to leak. It's like, you don't really have to risk that red balloon trying to get past your defenses because it's just a red balloon. But remember, never ever leave a yellow balloon because I've had a lot of traumatic experiences with yellow balloons in my time playing this game. Okay, glue strike on this round. That plus two damage, that's going to be some spicy meatballs. Just going to be spicy in general. You don't have the pain of not being able to do enough damage to round 76 regrow ceramics. And you know the pain that they, that round 76 would be if they were fortified regrowth ceramics. Now that would be very painful. Blue strike again. We're nearly there now to call to arms. And then after that, we're going to invest in a middle path ice tower. One of the best supporting towers that you can possibly have in Balloons Town Event 6. Because of the fact that it can permanently slow down Moab class balloons if you invest in the permafrost upgrade. Ooh, this round is looking very spicy, but not spicy enough to get through our defenses. Round 78, just one more wave of ceramics. Just one more wave. We're gonna use glue strike because it does come back pretty quickly. And I feel like using glue strike then and there was better than using call to arms, because I feel like for this round, we're going to definitely need it for all of these regrow rainbows. Ah, the love of round 79. Isn't it just fantastic when you can get overwhelmed by regrow rainbows? The sheer number of them? Sometimes it's not the individual regrow rainbow, but just all of them put together in one gigantic cluster, you know the word? Oh dear. The pain. The pain! I'm just trying to exercise to the chaos gods here because of the pain. The pain gives me power! No, it doesn't. It just gives me more suffering and pain. Pain upon pain upon pain upon pain. Never ending pain. But hey, we've got a ZMG on this round that's now affected by the glue strike. Would I get lost for a huge amount longer with the glue storm? Because it feels like it requires at least two lots of the glue storm to come back for its ability, for the glue storm aspect to go away, which is actually a better version of glue strike, because, well, this doesn't last for very long, even with the 001 upgrade of glue gunner in general. I've forgotten what it's called now. Stickier glue? I don't know now. All I do is play this game. I don't know the specifics of everything. Here we go, round 80 is coming to a close, and guess what? We shouldn't really leave these because they're yellow balloons, but we're going to leave them regardless so we can get our abilities back that bit sooner. What's your problem now? Next task is the ice tower. Let's go for 240 because we can't afford 250 at this given point in time. We will be able to do so at some point. And when we cast ability, when it is absolute zero, as long as they don't go into their children's status, so let's say ZMG to BFB, then they will receive a permanent slowdown in their movement speed. And combine that with Moab Glue and a Balloon Sabo in active in place, they're going to be crawling along. They're not going to be gliding across the battlefield. They're going to be crawling along. They're going to wish that they were never in existence because of how slow they're going. Doing very well so far. They're not making their way very far along the track. Oh, we've got absolute zero money now. I meant the amount of money needed to buy the absolute zero. Having absolute zero money, which means we have no money. We have spent the perfect amount on deflation mode to reduce our funds to zero. This is not deflation chimps, by the way. I don't even think, like, would you even want to do deflation chimps? Just, like, as a mode in general. Like, no monkey knowledge points, no continues, no, oh, I've forgotten what I is now. No income. Actually, there's no income anyways in deflation mode. No powers. And no, what was S again? Isn't it like no saves? No, I'm such a dumbass, it's no selling. Like deflation chimps, is that even a challenge, honestly? Because it just feels like, well, a slightly tweaked version of deflation already. By applying the absolute zero, they are now traveling a bit slower once they're out of their frozen stage. But the only downside is the fact that if you do it too soon, it means that the balloon will be instantly popped. And, well, the children balloon will not be affected by the permafrost effect. Which is annoying because it's applied to all of the balloon, including the innards of the balloon itself. What's taking this particular ZMG so long to be popped? We're doing the same amount of damage, but... is this bug? No, it's not bugged. It just felt like it was bugged because it was taking much longer to pop than the other ZMG was. Oh dear. Is it because the first target that it hits has more damage than the other targets that it hits? Imagine if there's like a pierce penalty where every time it goes through a balloon, the projectile itself gets weaker until at the point where it's run out of pierce and therefore it cannot damage anymore. Is that such a thing, a pierce penalty, when it comes to the damage itself? Like being able to go through like a certain number of balloons, but it's like if you get closer to the pierce cap, then each time the pierce hits a balloon, it gets weaker. Like that'd be, I think that's a dumb rule. I think I'm just making it up on the spot. Popped three of those ZMGs for some odd reason. But yet, for some other reason, I feel like with this last ZMG, we're going to absolutely struggle to pop it. Because it's me. It's me. It's the fed I encounter. Oh, wait. I encounter. Oh, I feel like I'll prefer that as a ZMG so that the overall RBE's movement is slower. RBE stands for Red Balloon Equivalent, by the way. How many red balloons can you comprise into one balloon? And the answer is many, the later you go along. And that is round 87. Done and dusted. I thought that was a red balloon, but I realized that would probably be a red balloon on round 400. Yay me. That was what Harley Gwen would say. Yay me. We should now invest in some balloon sabers. I think three is going to be enough because when it comes to that 25% of uptime, which we don't get, we can just replace that with absolute zero as a means of slowing down the balloons. Can we go through these two ZMGs, which are the things left to pop on round 88? We've done every now, and it's just these two huge slow behemoths. I call them behemoths sometimes and not balloons because, well, A, they begin with B, and B, because they also begin, well, they're behemoths at the end of the day. Doesn't one of them in their initials, like one of the words is behemoth? BFB Ron answers, only big fat behemoths. I've now made it canon. The red Moabs are called big fat behemoths. And nobody can tell me otherwise. One rule to not getting too many steals on your Absolute Zero Ice Monkey here is to activate Absolute Zero before activating Glue Storm or Glue Strike, sorry, so that you don't get that plus two damage on every single balloon that you are affecting with Absolute Zero itself. Otherwise, you're going to get three times the pops in which you would normally get anyways. Round 89 is... although sometimes it is unavoidable depending on circumstances. Round 89 is done. Round 90, our first encounter with DDTs. So slow those down with all the means that we have. I just realized we don't even have pickles.
But I want the pickles. We want the pickles.
But you're not always going to get the pickles, okay? Oh gosh, we're running out of Pierce here. And we have initiated the glue strike, and I don't want to steal too many pots. Okay, we've got quarter arms, lovely. Come on, go to work, at least laser shock, get that plus two damage with the glue strike implemented as well. I like to think that the laser shock does plus three rather than plus one while under a glue strike, because it's all forms of damage that should also be a damage that accumulates over time. They're making their way quite far down the track, which is a bit concerning. Yeah, for these last few rounds, I have to play the slow game because, as you can tell from the Dartling Gunner, it requires a little bit of micromanaging in order to get all of your shots to land on the balloons, which is not always going to be the case going back and forth. And that clears around there. So we're going to apply our pickles. We're going to apply our, was there everything that we could include? Oh yeah, Jerry's hot sauce. And I think that should be it until we can get the better invisibility potion so we can do more damage to camo balloons. Very handy for round 100 where the bat could pop over here. A little bit outside of the capacity of the submerged support. And submerged support doesn't always decamify balloons, especially if they're fast enough so that they can go through the radius of the submerged support quickly enough so that it's kind of in between the submerged support attacks that it does to decamify camo balloons. I know it sounds very confusing, but I swear it's less complicated than, let's say, a US selection. Getting their way to the end of the track here, and there goes round 92. Lovely. Round 93, we're going to invest in one more Sabo, not under the influence of the Alchemist, thank you very much. The Sabo, and once all of them are in range, we're going to put everything else down. And we should be able to take care of the rest of the DTs. Yeah. Once their lights go dim, not just going yellow because of decamify, but it's like, once their lights go dim, that's a sign that they are low on health. I think the neon DT is probably the best when it comes to visual feedback as to like if they're decamified or not, or if they're on low health or not. Because you can tell the difference between a light yellow and a dark yellow, or a light blue and a dark blue. The sun's skin tones are very subtle in their changes. Like, Pinata Bad is quite noticeable because it's obviously you can see more candy as time goes on when you lower its HP more and more. And with the Whale Bad, that one has the bandages that appear on it, which is visual feedback. That is something in which players can take away as in like, because I'm doing enough damage, it's going down in HP and I can see the stages in which the HP is at. Whereas some balloons, you gotta look really carefully. Update 42 predictions. Ninja Kiwi, we still don't feel that the Sky Shredder is quite right when it comes to its price. Yeah, we're gonna increase the price even more because we feel like it, because it's still too good to use. Debatably, it is very good, but 40, nearly 50k in hard, like that is a huge amount to ask for essentially a tower that is not very strong per projectile, but it's just, it has a ton of them. Let's get our abilities back, and then our round 94 will be complete. There we go, round 95. What's going to be on this round? A huge number of DDTs. I know it's not a huge amount, but 30 sounds like a huge amount of DDTs to me. Thank you very much. Okay, here they come. What do we have on board? A bunch of abilities to help us out here. Another one. Let's use quarter ones. Once we have all of them out, then we will use the other abilities at hand here. I think that was just about right. Yeah, that was just about right when it comes to our usage of it. I guess that timing there, but I'm glad that happened. Why are you not popping, ceramics? Come off it. Feels like I summoned an endless number of barrage against you. Ain't like, nah, I don't feel like falling down today. I'll fall down when I feel like it. Like, look at them. Like we definitely have pickles, so we're doing the damage needed. But it's like sometimes the damage is not. You've got. Really? That is so dumb. Let's use our sabo and our call to arms a bit sooner. I should have realized I need to use sabo a bit sooner. And then once everything is out, then let's micromanage a little bit more. Because like, it feels like at the moment I'm not dealing the damage and I need to constantly prioritize the lingering ceramics and makes her way to the far end of the track here. And I'm not going to worry about those few regrowths. I'm just going to concentrate on these DTs. And for some odd reason, that time was far more successful. Brilliant. But at the same time, why? I'm glad, but why not the last time around? The pain of being a 2 Megapops player at times. This is not the first time this has been done, by the way. This is my own kind of personal record sort of thing. Personal achievement, personal accomplishment. Don't need to be the first one to do it. If you think this has taken a long time, remember, there are people out there that have done exactly the same thing, but with base Dartling Gunner and not Hydra Rocket Pods. Fun. We are so close to the end of round 96. I can almost taste it. There goes round 96. Lovely. Fortified ZMGs. You have no chance. Let's just use those. Let's put the money on there, and do we need Glue Storm? I do want to Spike Storm at some point, and I do want to use Rejuve Potion with that Spike Storm so we can take down the bad that bit sooner. Debatable as to whether or not I want it or not. Like, with the last few rounds, like, I'm just going to preemptively put this down. Like, we're going to have those in place, then we're going to have the pickles and the sharpening stone. Don't need anything else. That would actually be even better when there was more damage to the better sharpening stone. Thanks for the unnecessary change to that, Ninja Kiwi. There goes the first ZMG. Let's try and keep the other ZMG as a ZMG and not scattered about, so that hopefully we'll be able to get all these layers. A ZMG is like an onion, confirmed. There are many layers to it. And then underneath that, it still feels like there's an endless number of layers. Oh dear, we are all onions at the end of the day. We are all Shrek. That's a horrible thought to think. Wait a minute. We don't have the pickles. We need the pickles, for goodness sakes. I can't believe I forgot about that, actually. I was wondering if we were doing enough damage or not. And the answer is, well, we could have done that damage even sooner, to be honest. Yeah, these fortified ceramics are a doozy. Are we able to go through these layers or not? I hope so. And come on. Okay, good. Now they're fortified ceramics. Let us deal with fortified Moabs, I mean. Let's just deal with the rest of them. Can we deal with the rest of them, though? That is the question. They're stuck, which is good, but is it stuck enough? And the answer is that they shall stick. Round 98, arguably the best, the most RBE round in all of Chimps. Is this round fun? In a way, yes, because it's a very big challenge. It's like, if you lose on round 98, then you know that you've got to work on a better strategy in order to get through the round itself. And no, we're not using rejuve potion on this round, we're using it on round 100. Although, Geraldo, we'll get two rejuve potions at the end of this round, thanks to Geraldo going to level 20, which his stock only ever replenishes on his first time going to level 20. To those people that still think that, well, if you sell Geraldo and get him back to level 20, you can restock all of his Paragon power totems back. That's not the case. Right, the Fortify Balloons have been exterminated. Now it's just the huge bulk of the Pierce of this round to deal with in the form of ZOMGs. And guess what, Mwebs? And Ceramics, Patrick. Yeah, the Jerry's Fire has popped the last ZOMG, which was something I didn't hope for. I was hoping to compartmentalize each of the ZOMGs into different segments of this round so I can deal with every single ZOMG individually. But I guess I'm gonna have to go with a harder route of trying to deal with all of this at once. Fun times if you're me. Let's see. Overclock again. I don't want to use another quarter arms again. Freeze them. Oh gosh. I don't like the scenario that we present ourselves here because all of these other balloons can attack them. Don't attack them, please. Please, with a capital P, please. Okay, Ninja Sabo now useless. And Geraldo's at now level 20. Good. DDTs, fortified ones this time. Okay, that's all of the DDT summon, so use that to zero. And we have this round in the bag. Can we do the rest of this without purchasing anything else besides rejuve potions? Now that is a challenge in and of itself, if you ask me. Possibly. I don't know, we've got 20k. We'll have 20k by the end of this. 20k in the bank! I wish I can use this in another game of chips. And there goes the last of that. Okay, so what are we going to do here? Well, we're going to wait for quarter arms to come back. We're going to use glue, quarter arms, then the spike storm so we can get 50% more potential out of that. And then use rejuve potion. We're going to use the same again. Use that again, and then I hope that one more will suffice when it comes to our endeavors here. So use another one, use one of those, use both of those again, and I hope that might be it. But then again, I don't think that's done enough pops though. That's the question. I may need to do it so that I compartmentalize the rejuve potions, so when the bad is around like multiple sections of the map, then we'll do it there, because I feel like I didn't do them quite so well when it comes to the spacing out of the buildings themselves. I mean the abilities themselves. Yeah, I feel like that's a bit too late around the round, sorry. Can I do here? Not a huge amount. We've got 17k left in the tank. Can we do it on this attempt? I don't think so. I don't want to use absolute zero again if I can help it, but feels like we might need to use it at some point. That's just going too quickly. That's my prop. Nah, this is too much for us. This is way too much for us. This is, I know we've met our goal, but this is, no, it's too much for us. Yeah, we need to use our spike storms more accordingly so that hopefully the spikes are able to affect multiple areas of a track where the bad is at that given point in time. Let's hope this time results will stick in place. I've got my mouse over the number 4 just in case they do pop. Okay, so how many pops have we stolen from this? 22,000. That should be okay, actually. I think from our other pops from the other towers that we've had. So, 24. Geraldo sold him barely anything. You know what? Now is the time for that perishing potions, because it's not going to be a hindrance whatsoever. A moment set before disaster. Literally a moment set before disaster. Knowing me and my luck with perishing potion, it's going to be an absolute stinker of an idea. Okay, let's try and space out these BFAs so that they're not affecting us as much with their movement speed. And yeah, let's use quarter arms here. Let's get those pots down, done and dusted and all that jazz. And yeah, we're there with Hydra Rocket Pods. Thank you all so much for watching, everybody. Hope it's been a lovely video for you to watch. For me, it's been over an hour of recording. Well, it's definitely going to be shorter for you, but I'm just showing my feedback from my end here. Three engine and three abilities, which is something so satisfying about symmetry in that regard. So yeah, even a tier 3 tower like the Hydra Rocket Pods can do so much when you give it the correct support. So your overclock, your absolute zero for slowing down, your balloon sabo for slowing down, your glue strike for more damage, your spike storm for the bad. When you put all of these things together, even the weakest towers can be very powerful. Thank you all so much for watching, everybody. Hope you enjoyed the video. Let me know what you thought of this video by commenting down in the comment section below. And enjoy your day, whatever it is that you are doing. Thank you all so much. Thank you so much for watching, and take care of yourselves, everybody.